I'm gonna do a basic tutorial of how to install window film in the commercial or residential applications. So we use this appeal board over here. So this is gonna be our testing. The number one thing that you have to do, it's gonna be clean the windows. Before that, you have to make sure you have the right tools, you know? So you can't show up to like a residential job showing up with like a Blue Max squeegee and stuff like that, because we need something more rigid to be able to push out all the water. So the first things first is you have to have the right tools. Right tools, your basic is you need your cutter, and it's not much. You need a squeegee to push out all the water. This is my hard squeegee to push out all the water, and then just a clean squeegee. And then that's really all you need. And then maybe a couple hard cards and stuff, but you have to have a good squeegee to be able to push out all the water. Cause if not, you're gonna have issues with it bubbling up and stuff like that. And you get callbacks and, you know, push all the water out. It's just a disaster. So use a good squeegee. And the way you squeegee is really important as well. So I'm gonna go over all that stuff. First things first, have your tools. Make sure you have everything you need. So pretty much your punch list should be your Ofo blade, cleaning squeegee, power squeegee, and then a couple cards, paper towels, obviously. First things first is we have to prep the site, and every window is different. Wooden, this scenario over here, I have rubber gaskets over here, and they're pretty tucked in. If they were overlapping a lot, I would probably trim the gaskets just so I could get a straight edge. If you look at this top corner, I don't know if I could get it on tape, but there's a piece of rubber. If I were tinning this, like for real, I would trim this over here just to make my life a lot easier, and I get a lot cleaner work just like that. So I just trim what's exposed. It doesn't affect the seal in the window because all I'm doing is cutting off what's exposed. So now, see, I could run up my film up there nice and crispy, and I get a lot cleaner work. So that's the first things first, is I'm gonna look at my seals. See, wooden panes, obviously, you're gonna have to clean the crap out of them. And you know, that is the most important part of window tinting, is your cleaning process and how you prepare your window, because that's gonna reflect the final product. Right now, I'm gonna tint this side. So I have pretty clean area to work with. So I'm gonna tint the top side. First things first, I get here, before I even clean anything, I'm gonna look at my rubbers. These are nice and tight and clean. Over here, I already trimmed the excess off, but I could trim all this little excess just so it's consistent and it looks uniform. So I'm gonna trim that, go to the top, trim whatever little there is there that's exposed only. I'm not digging my knife into it. I'm keeping it flat with the frame. Okay, so I'm just cutting what's exposed and I'm not going into the actual frame. So I'm gonna do that, bam, bam, bam. So now I got my rubbers off. Okay, so now that I got the rubbers off, depending on the condition of the windows, you know, this is fairly clean because we use it indoors, but you're gonna get a lot of times, they're gonna be really, really filthy. And then as far as like the slip solution, all I do is I fill this up. Now I don't need it to be too soapy. So I just literally do like a little, I don't know, what is that? 2 count for my slip solution. So I fill up the bottle, do like a 2 count. If it's a hotter day, I put a little bit more soap because it dries up faster, and I need it sometimes to slip it into position. So even the way you mix your water is important. So if there's not enough soap on it and you spray it and you try to move the film, it's going to get stuck on you. So make sure you use the right amount of soap. And you'll learn, you know, the more you do it, you'll be able to eye it. But first things first, I cut my rubbers. That's done. Now I'm going to start doing my cleaning process. So I'm gonna spray. So first I wet. I usually soak everything, okay? And usually I have my tank, so I'll usually blast the corners and stuff, but I'm not gonna do all that right now. Okay, and then after you do that, you're gonna take your 6-inch scraper, okay? Make sure it's a stainless steel scraper, and I usually go upwards here, and I push my edges just around, okay? Because one, I don't wanna scratch the frame, so I always push into it. So I go just like that. Okay, and when I do this, I overlap my strokes, meaning everything gets scraped twice. So if you look at this section, I go down on it here, okay? Then I just go halfway to where I did it, and I go again. So now each section, and it's uniform, okay? That way, if I see that there's no water on it, it means it's scraped already. And that's how I keep track of what's been clean. So right here, I'm just overlapping 50%. So if you were to be able to see my water line, it's right here. My handle lines up with my water line. So this is dry. So this dry spot is getting squeegeed again. And I'm just want to do that just to reinsurance that everything gets scraped 2 times, just like that. So that's my first section. I'm going to scrape everything in a uniform manner. Okay, my edges, I usually push them out. Okay, and it depends. Wooden frames are a little bit different process. But yeah, you got to do the stainless steel, scrape it. It's a must. So now I scrape this. Now I'm going to wet this again. Okay, this time I'm gonna, a lot of people don't do this step. And I do this because my uncle engraved this into my brain. It's just, we sponge them. Anything loose that's in there, I usually run this part of the sponge against the frame, and I even clean the frame over here. I'm cleaning the frames. Okay, because when I spray the water and the water hits it, let's say I spray right over here and it drips down, any dirt that might be on that frame is going to go over here, and you're going to 100% be able to see it when you do your install. So right here, we're going to sponge it. When I'm sponging, I'm just going crazy with the sponge. And it just takes an extra, 30 seconds to do this step, but it'll save you from doing redos. Okay, so I'm just sponging off the frame, and I'm rubbing the inside corner in here really, really good, just like that. So we sponge off the film, then the frame. After we sponge it, I'm going to get a piece of towel. I usually use 3, and then I'm going to run my towel across the half on the frame, half on the glass, just like this. Okay, that way I'm drying off the frame and I'm drying off the glass, just like that, all the way. And I'm cleaning this as much, getting this as dry as I can. Okay, see how much dirt I got off this frame? So now I could get a nice squeegee going. Okay, so I start off in the dry and I just follow whatever I just did. Go down, up and around here. Bam. Okay. Okay, and always wipe your squeegee blade afterwards because you don't want that dirty water back in there. I scraped this, I sponged this, cleaned the frames, trimmed my rubbers. Now I'm ready for the install process. The method I'm gonna use for this one is gonna be a reverse backwards, but I just found this piece of scrap around the shop, so I don't wanna use a waste of full piece here. So I'm just gonna do my back roll sideways. So usually when you do your back roll, you run it up and down like this. Okay, but for this size, just so I can show you how I do my corners, I'm gonna run it this way. Okay, so first things first is when you do a back roll, you kind of unroll it a little bit. And the point of this is just so I could wet the inside like this. And I wet both sides. Okay, once I wet both sides, I'm just gonna re-roll it back up. Okay, now the hardest part of new installers is getting this liner. And then here's a trick that I do too all the time. If your roll is too loose, I like to tighten it up, because sometimes, for example, if this roll isn't tight and I have like my hand like this wide, this is pretty wide for me to try to back roll it, it's a lot easier to manage the film if it's smaller. So the way I roll it is I just pull this out like this, and then I just stick my thumb here and I just start turning this just like that. Okay, and I'm obviously turning the right way, which is going to be clockwise, to tighten this up. Okay, and then little by little, you'll see that this is going to get nice and small. See, so now I got a lot smaller. Push it back in. Now this is a lot easier to handle than if it were bigger. I always start with the top corners over here. Usually, like for me, I do this a lot. I'm able to kind of just play with my thumb here, and I'll just feel that, like, for that top layer. Just like that. And this is the harder part. So from here, I'm gonna run it and I'm gonna grab. Now I'm separate. Okay, so now, so I unroll it. You know, I did the unrolling part. You know, I wet the inside, I wet the outside. Okay, and then the hardest part, what new installers have a hard time doing, even me sometimes on some days, I'm just doing a bunch of windows and I get frustrated, but it's just separating the liner from the film. And usually if you lightly rub your thumb against the top, you're able to separate it, just like I did right there. I did that really easily right now, but you know, sometimes it happens on the first try, sometimes it doesn't. And then I always go for this corner first, because usually that's the corner that I'm either cutting off. So whatever part of the film that I am touching right now, I usually cut off. So now I got my finger in here. I got it separated. Okay, so now I'm just gonna kind of run my fingers, like I walk my hand up just to this part over here, and I'm gonna replace it with my thumb. Now that I have my thumb in there, I have my bottle here, and I just use this part just like that, just to separate it. Okay, because I wet the inside of the film already, now this liner is gonna stick to my roll as I unroll it. So right now, if I unroll it, okay, if I get to this part, anytime I unroll it, I always wet it. Okay, just so if there's any little dust particles, I can push them out. But you see right here, okay, I have the liner and the film, so now when I unroll it, it's gonna be coming off with it. So I'm gonna wet this here. I'm getting nice. I'm gonna overlap the three tops just to show you how to squeeze you when it's in that scenario. Because a lot of guys like to pre-cut the film a lot, and that's okay. You know, I just find it a lot faster if you guys just slap the piece on, squeeze you the right way. That way it comes out nice and clean. Okay. And then so when I'm over here and I'm spraying, I'm make sure I aim my nozzle downwards just so I don't spray the top. Okay. If I spray up over here, once again, the water hits here, goes down, now it's dirty. Then you're going to get little bumps everywhere. Okay, so I'm just going to make sure I have a good wet surface. Okay, and then I have the beginning part of whatever is exposed of the film, I have it wet. Okay, so now I'm going to go and I'm going to overlap it. I have a straight edge on top, but just for tutorial's sake, look, I'm just going to grab it over here. And remember I said this is the side I'm touching. This is the side I'm going to cut off. Okay, so I'm just going to overlap it just like that. Now I just press and now I just unroll it. Okay, and I'm just looking at the alignment of my film. This happens a lot, real common. It's called tunneling. You have to make sure that you're watching out so it doesn't tunnel on you. Okay, so I literally just unroll it. And if this were go up and down, this is not a pressure sensitive film. Okay, this is a dry adhesive. Okay, so it comes off the liner a lot easier than a film that's pressure sensitive. And then from here, as I'm going, I like to always just keep it wet. So I'll open it up and spray it. Okay, right now it's a little bit awkward for me because usually I would do this window up and down, not side to side. But I do this side to side technique when the window's really, really big and we have to seam it. So we would do one piece and then stack another piece on the bottom. So this is a technique that you would use as well, doing it sideways. It's a little bit harder than going up and down. It takes practice, but once you get it down, then it's not too bad. So now I didn't pre-cut my film, so I'm just working out of the fat scrap that I have. So I'm just gonna cut off whatever I have over. So now we got to this part. We got the film on the glass. That's probably the hardest part, okay, of tinning, getting it on cleanly. Okay, so now I'm gonna take my liner off, which is right here. I'm watching my film, making sure I don't crease it. Okay, so now from here, you have to be careful that like stuff like this, it might be hard to see, but there's like a big finger over here. Usually before I start squeezing everything, I'll wet everything and I'll just massage it out, you know? So I'll push these fingers outwards just like that, just so I don't get any creases, you know? Because especially the bigger the window is, the more waste, you can't waste a piece because these are big pieces that you're gonna go through. And notice how I'm not pushing the edges in yet. Okay, I don't want to touch the edges until they're trimmed. So now I have this locked in. Okay, and this is where a lot of people mess up, is the squeezing part. There's a certain way you have to squeeze this for it to come clean. Okay, so first things first, I'm going to make the letter T. Okay, and this is straight from the manufacturer, the way I'm showing you guys how to install the film. If you guys ever read the manuals, I know nobody ever does, but they'll tell you how to install. So first things first, I want to make sure that everything's nice and wet. Okay, I don't want to go dry because if you go dry and you go down, you're going to rip the film. This is really thin film. So first, I'm going to make my letter T. Okay, so I'm going to go straight down just like that. Boom. Okay, then I'm going to go to the side here. Okay, so now we make the letter T. I go here and I go down. And I don't go to the very, very top. Okay, you see my frames over here? And I started squeezing. I left like an inch and a half from the top. Okay, and this is, I just call this anchoring the film so it doesn't move on you. Okay, now from here, I have my line from where I squeezed it. If you want to get closer, I line up middle halfway. So you see my handle, just how when I scrape, lines up with that. So I start pushing that water up and I stop about an inch away from the frame. Okay, right here. I push and I'm overlapping each stroke. 50%, okay, even 30%, so I go less. So each part of the film gets squeezed multiple times, just like that, okay? And the number one mistake that new installers make, and that I used to make a lot, is they squeegee all the way, like that, okay? Now what happens then, you see how I just pulled back? Watch, I'll do it again. When I go here and I pull back, you see how it lifts back? When it lifts back like that, it pulls in dirt with it that I wasn't able to clean that's inside the frame. So that's why you'll get a lot of contamination on the edges. If you have that issue of contamination around the edges, is because when you're squeezing all the way through. And then when you pull back, when it pulls back, it brings in all that dirt. You can already see a little bit of dirt accumulating right there. So before I squeegee this whole outside, I need to make sure I trim it. And then you can use whatever you want in the beginning. You know, a lot of times if I were doing this normal, I would freehand it, you know, just because I have a little bit of practice now. But when I was just starting, I would always use a card, some sort of like five-way tool. So when I started, I would always use one of these guys, and I still do sometimes, and I'm not against these. Rather than freehanding it, sometimes there's more margin for error. What this does, it gives you a little gap just like that, and you have to have that gap, okay? And my mistake in the beginning was that I would go too tight to the frames. Let me see if I could do it. I would go really, number one most common mistake with installers is they go too tight to the frame over here. So when I cut this over here, just like that, they try to get a really clean install. Okay, now check this out. If I try to, and I clean this really, really well, but I'll show you what could happen if I get too tight. So from here, now when I try to blot this out, I get this little, these fingers, a bunch of these little like bumps that pop up in the beginning. And I still do to this day use these five-way tools over here. Okay, and all you do is you just run it across over here. And then when it comes to the, depending on the frame, from here, I just poke my blade in the corner. Okay, so from here, my corner is right here. So I'll just poke the corner like this, and then I'll just flare it out this way. Okay, and then you can pull the piece out if you want. I put my finger here, and I just rip out just like that. And that's going to be a good corner right there. Then from there, I bring this guy on the inside, and I do want a good little gap on this. So from here, I just use, what is this? One, two clicks. The blade's barely exposed, and I just go on the inside here, and I just slide it just like that, boom. Okay, and you can't really see it, but there's a little gap there, okay? And I need that gap if I wanna be able to push all the water out. If not, water's gonna get stuck. So now that I have that cut out, okay, let me cut my top again. Look, I just go here, I push this in, okay? And then I just get my blade on the inside, and we're just gonna follow nice and easy. Okay, now when I, let's say it's hanging like this, it's a really big window, I have to put my finger here and pull away this way, always, because if not, you might tear into it. Okay, so you see that I trimmed this side's ready to go. I'm gonna spray it. I'm gonna do my squeegee again. Okay, I go here. I'm gonna give it another squeegee. I anchor it straight down the middle, but this time I'm gonna go all the way out. And now because I have that little gap, okay, that water is able to get pushed out just like that. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, you see? So this is a common mistake. What happens? I don't know if you guys can see this little finger or bubble right here. Can you see it or no? Not really, huh? That's just water. I'm too tight to the frames, okay? So if that happens, you have to shave a little bit off of it, okay? And that's where you waste a lot of time, is going back and trying to shave a little bit. So might as well just leave a little gap from the beginning. So you just go here, boom, okay. And I just take like a sliver off for the corner. The top isn't squeegeed yet. I don't want it to be squeegeed. I find my corner, okay, and I'm just gonna poke it with the tip of my Ulfa. And then from there, I poke it, and then I pull my blade out. And then from there, I always just rip a piece out just like that. And then I can push that corner in with my finger. Okay, and then from here, I'm gonna lightly just push this in. Okay, so from here, now, all I have to do is run this little five-way tool. Okay, there you go. Pull away this way, here, down. Okay, then I'm gonna cut. Same difference. Okay, so now it's all trimmed out. Don't need this no more. We're gonna spray and do our final squeegee. Okay, now that I have it trimmed out, I could push the top water out. Okay, I push it all out. Okay, before, I don't wanna push it because it comes back down. So I push it, bam. Overlap everything 50%. One, two, go down. Squeegee, 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 just like that. Okay, everything looks pretty good. Okay, so once it's done, then the final step is to blot everything out. Okay, so you can use a hard card, really anything, just hard. So we're just gonna wrap a paper towel around my card here, and I'm just gonna just dry out the edges, make sure everything's locked in nice and tight. Any little water bubble that might be there, I'm gonna push it out right now. Okay, so push, 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 push. Okay, everything's blotted out. Wipe it down. All right, and that's all she wrote. For whatever reason you have to move the film, you could always reset it, but you're gonna get like a margin for error. So let's say, just for the sake of it, that I have like a little something under my film here. It's obviously not gonna be this big, but this is just for demo purpose. You know, getting rid of this, sometimes if you don't do it the right way, you know, it could cost you the piece of film. But usually if it's there, I'm always gonna start by a corner and I always just wet the whole area. Okay, and then usually I use like either my finger, and I'm just gonna start lifting. As I start lifting, I'm gonna stick this part to this part just like that. Here, I'm gonna wet it. Okay, so now I don't wanna try to wet this area too much because the water is gonna get pushed in there, and if there's dirt, it's gonna get sucked in. So from here, I'll just pull whatever I need to do. You gotta make sure my hands are already wet, but always wet your hands, and then kind of just clean out whatever you have to. Okay, and I'm keeping this part dry. Then I'm just gonna wet this. Okay, reset it. Here, spray again. Re-squeegee. Okay, just like that.